In this example, you will study about defining the settings for a table, listing the parts in a drawing. And you can also input other information, such as the bill of materials for making the parts. So, let's begin. First, create a table based on the standard AutoCAD style. For this table, define four columns, and the data will be input on a screen. Now, in the Set Cell Styles option, you define the display for each type of data in the columns and the rest of the cells in the table, and display the data on the drawing. Then, on this row, you type the following items, each one for a separate cell, the part number, description, and quantity. Now, as we already have a previously created table, let's start creating a new table style. Click Table Style to do this. After that, click New and define the name for the new style. Then click Continue to input the necessary settings. Select Starting Table on a new Display dialog box, and then you can select the previously created table. This makes it possible to use the structure from the previously created table and apply it to the new style. You can see the information inserted in the column legends is also imported into the new style. Now select the header option in Cell Styles. Change the text height field value to 5 on the text tab. This way the table column legends will display larger text than other display texts. Then, after inputting all settings, click OK. You see the new style is now displayed on the list. To use it, select the style on the Tables panel before enabling the tool for sketching tables. This way, the table will adhere to all the defined properties, and then you just need to insert the data for the part in the drawing. So now our example is finished. So in this example, you have learned about creating a table style for listing the drawing bills of materials. This way, creation of tables is faster and easier.